What the heck is Instagram and how can it help your medical practice? Today we're going to talk about some Instagram basics. Copy is the description that goes along with your photo and your video. And if you watch one of our previous videos, you know that initially you only get a couple of lines of text below your photo or video. So people have to find the first part interesting, and then they can read more, and then they can expand out to the entire thing. So copy is extremely important because even though we're delivering photos and video in kind of a quick-fire manner, once you have someone's attention, you do want to deliver a longer message. So it really helps to write about what's in the photo or video and then relate that to a bigger topic or explain more or go more in depth or just have an opportunity and a platform where they're actually going to read what you're writing. Now keep in mind, there's really no other place where you can write something and have your patients read it. If you put it on the website, you're hoping they come to it, and probably not going to read, you know, the latest blog unless you force email it out to everyone and get some traffic that way. But if someone likes an Instagram post, they'll probably take a look at what you have to say about it, especially if they know that your page often has good copy. So what are some examples? Like, for example, maybe you post a picture of foods that you should avoid for oral care, or foods that you have to be particular. Maybe it's soda, maybe it's a pile of sugar, or whatever the case may be, an interesting picture of it. Then in the copy, you would write about why soda is bad. You know, very basic example, lots of people do that. You would share tips and tricks or oral hygiene techniques, right? So it's the information that goes along with the photo. So it's your opportunity to actually educate or explain or even just have some of your personality come through. And that copy, believe it or not, is extremely important. You want to make sure that it's well written, that it doesn't have errors. Don't write like your text messaging. Don't just put random things in there. You want to put some thought into it. And I had one client tell me that this made it really daunting because when he thought Instagram was just take a picture and post it, he can do that, no problem. But as soon as he had to realize he had to write copy, he was very intimidated because what do I write? How do I say it? It kind of slowed this whole process down. So while you don't want to overthink it or put too much pressure on yourself, you do want to spend a little bit of time and energy on the copy of the post. And if you're on Instagram, you know, you probably know this, but scroll through and read what people are writing. And you'll see some of them write a couple words and it's not that interesting and you move on. And some of them will write, you know, multiple lines and it'll be really engaging and it'll get you thinking and it'll share it. So as a business, considering you always have business intentions here, whether it's to promote your services, whether it's to show off a new product, whether it's to feature a new line of frames that just came in, you want to make sure you expand and explain. And remember, people are only going to read it if they're interested. So if you know you have someone who's interested in your business paying attention, what would you want to say to them? And use those kind of guidelines to start off. But copy is very important. A picture with no copy isn't going to get you very far. And most importantly, you're missing out on the platform that you've been given to spread whatever messages you want, thank people, interact with people. And usually the copy is what's going to get people to comment and interact with you, because in the copy you can ask questions, you can put out messages, you can ask for people's opinion, you could see if they have similar experiences. You can get some interaction a lot more easily in the copy than the video. And lastly, if you are posting a video, which is very popular, you have to remember again where people are using Instagram. There's a lot of times when people are on Instagram and they're gonna have their sound off, right? If they're at work, if they're in a public environment, they don't want people hearing what sound their phone is putting out. So a lot of times if there's a video, people will watch it, but they won't be able to hear what you're saying. So especially in those scenarios, if you're not able to do subtitles on your videos, you want the copy to reflect what you're talking about in the video so they can at least get an idea of what you're saying to go along with the video content that you're putting out.